G'day all.
Recently I bought my first mountain bike in many years. I was looking originally for a second-hand bike between $500 and $1,000 Australian, and I noticed this Hasa bike for $650, brand new, advertised by Cycling Deal seller. They have a website, cyclingdeal.com.au, and I noticed in the ad there was a web address for the bike manufacturer, hasa.com.tw. Looking at the bike on their site, it looked good, but there's only this photo online that I could find, which is obviously stock from the manufacturer. It's nice that it's high resolution, but it doesn't really give you a view around the bike. So my aim in this video is to give a view around the bike and give my first impressions from having ridden it only a couple of times so far. I've already replaced the handlebar, as you can see, because the bar that the bike came with is quite narrow at 60 centimetres. It would have been nice if it came with a 70 centimetre bar, which I would have kept, but as it is, I went with an Eastern 68.5 centimetre bar, and I would even consider going a bit wider than that. Here's a view of the front brakes and fork. It's got 180mm rotors front and back. You can see these bits of tape here on the head tube. I put those there just to prevent cable rubbing on the paintwork. The plastic bit you can see there, I didn't actually realise that was what that's for. But I guess I'll just keep both on for now. You can get a bit of a perspective on the welding work and the apparent strength of the frame in these shots. Also, you don't really see this angle in the one shot you see online. The cross-section of the top tube and the down tube you can see is a bit of a triangle. And overall, it looks really clean and well-constructed. It's also difficult in that picture to see on the top tube there where it says the model name in black and red, which adds a nice bit of balance to the colour scheme. These are the pedals that come with the bike, possibly a bit small but strong. There's quite a bit of branding on the bike, as you can see here. One of the stickers on the wheel rims can be removed. The other one has a serial number on it, so you'd probably want to keep that one. These are the Elixir 1 brakes that come with the bike. Some people say they're not so good in reviews, etc., but from my limited riding so far, they seem quite powerful, can lock up either wheel quite easily. I guess it comes down to whether extended use makes them lose performance, etc., but so far they're good. These are the Joytec hubs that it comes with. Have no reason to think that they won't last. And here's a view of the rear hub and the rear derailleur. Here's the front derailleur. The adjustment screws and the cable coming in. Incidentally, the derailleurs actually came pretty well perfectly adjusted straight from the factory, which is good. You can see only one bottle mount here on the down tube. You can see the cable routing there as well. I'm told that you can mount a bottle and a pump at the same time. I've got one of those pumps that's offset to the side a little bit, but I haven't tried that yet. Here's the remote lockout cable for the fork there, going up to the trigger on the handlebar. The way that works is you push this lever forward to lock the suspension, then you push the button on the left to release it on the go. You can see there the length of cables that you get on the bike. It could be a bit of a tight stretch on a longer bar, but you'd probably just end up leaving them where they are, or maybe switch the brakes to the inner position because the levers cover quite a bit of the grip area if you were using a 70cm plus bar. These handlebar clamp bolts here should require about 5 or so newton meters to tighten up, according to resources I found on the net, but the manual here says 17 to 19, so I went to tighten up to that level and it seemed to take some time, and I ended up busting a bolt. 5 or so should be fine. Stick to that and stop when you get there. They're pretty common and easily replaceable, and I don't think it would really damage the bar, but save yourself the trouble. The way my bike came, you can see there's a little bit of brake rub. It doesn't really slow the wheel down, but I understand it shouldn't rub at all. All it does is just make this little sound here. I tried reseating the brakes and pushing the pistons back into the cylinders a bit, but maybe it needs a bleed if it has a little too much brake fluid in the system. I might adjust that myself, but it doesn't really seem to be much of a problem at this stage, although that sound can be a little bit annoying. Interestingly, on the actual bike and the paintwork, it shows hasabike.com.tw, but that doesn't seem to work, so I guess they changed their site at some stage. One nice touch I hadn't mentioned is that on the bottom of the downtube and the top of the chainstay, they've put transparent frame tape to keep the paintwork from getting chipped. So what are my overall impressions of the bike? It's fun to ride, which is the main thing. It's got a good level of components for the price range, and it seems well constructed, so I think it will last the test of time. And that's pretty much what I was looking for. And what will you need to do if you buy one too? Here's a few things to consider. You'll need to attach and torque the handlebar to the correct level, about 5 newton meters, with a torque wrench. Tighten the headset to the appropriate level so it doesn't move around. Torque the stem to the steerer, also to the correct level. You'll need to grease the pedal threads and attach the pedals. Grease the seat post and insert that, lubricate the chain, pump the tires, torque the seat to the seat post because if you don't it will sag down a bit like mine did on a bit of rough terrain, and maybe reseat the brakes by loosening the bolts, squeezing the lever and re-tightening the bolts back to 6 or 7 newton meters, and then it should be good to ride. I'll put some links in the video description to help out with some of these things. Finally, a few things I'd like to try in the future. I might like to convert to a 2x10 setup with a bash guard to protect the front chain wheels. Also, because my road bike is a 2x and I think 3x involves a bit too much gear changing, which could be covered by the cassette, which has an appropriate selection of cog choices anyway. I'd like to try a slightly longer handlebar and an air sprung fork at some stage. Overall, it seems a good mid-range platform to get into the sport, so I hope this has been informative for you, and maybe I'll have some more to review in the future. This is the box that the Hasa Gallant 5.0 comes in.
It's got a few instructions and warnings here. Can have a look through that. It's got the model number there. Gallant 5.014 for 2014, and 18 inch is the frame size I got. 27.5-inch wheels.
The 2014 version only comes in one colour. I believe the next version comes in two colours, one for the SRAM version and one for the Shimano version, and they look great. I would have loved to get one of those, but this one looks good anyway. And the actual frame looks exactly the same as far as I can tell.
Well, it says their net weight is about almost 14 kilos, but the frame is fairly substantial looking. We'll see more of that later. And I guess I'm just comparing it only to my road bike over here, which is more like
10.5 kilos and maybe 9 to 9.5 without the accessories like mudguard, light, the bag under the seat and the pedals.
And get ready to have a look inside and see what's in this thing. You got the stem loosely mounted here. You can see it's moving freely, and the fork down there is not. The RockShox XC32K. Some helpful hints on the beefy frame. Wear a helmet. That's always a good idea. You should always do that. Check your brakes. Do that too. Do not ride at night. Well, I guess you can if you got lights. And read the owner's manual. I'll probably have to do that to put it together. You got the got a wheel down here, front wheel. It's separated from the frame by a bit of cardboard so it doesn't scratch it up. Got the rear wheel down there and the brakes pre-mounted there. And the cassette is on, that wheel is mounted. Got the seat over there. Got the cranks down there mounted also. It comes with the shifters and brake lines all set up already, so you can see those down there, and they actually are pre-mounted on the handlebar in there, which is handy. Save some technical questions for the DIY people like me that will be assembling this. And a box of goodies down there, so let's get this thing out and Okay, here's how it looks out of the box. You've got the stem flipped around. Get an idea in this head tube area how substantial the frame looked. It should be well capable of off-roading, despite the fact that half the bikes in the shop seem to have stickers on them saying, warning, don't take them off-road, which kind of defeats the purpose of buying a mountain bike with a big-ass suspension fork. So there's the rock shocks in there. Brake lines and brakes pre-mounted. There's the bottom of the handlebar with the lines going to it. This is how it comes in the box. You've got all the pieces cable tied to each other for efficient packing size. This disc here is protected by some sort of plastic thingy right there, and cable tied to the frame, separated by a bit of cardboard so it doesn't scratch the paint or scuff it, chip it off or anything. You can see around here, cable tied again. There is cable tie also holding the seat to the back wheel. The back wheel is pre-mounted with the cassette and everything. The brakes on there, there's some sort of plastic thingy here protecting the rear quick release. Here's just a quick view of the other side of how it's come straight out of the box with the seat cable tied to the wheel, the cranks protected, and well, most of the paintwork protected. There's the handlebar there, and the stem and the fork. So back to here in the little box, looks like you get some reflecty bits and pieces in the bag there. I don't think I'll really be using much of that. In here, presumably that's the skewer for the front wheel. Get rid of that. Some RockShox material. Just documentation and instructions, and I don't know what those are. And the manual. Exciting stuff. Let's put it together. Just quickly, you just get a bit of a view of the welding work here. Looks pretty nice on the outside. There's a pretty beefy chain stays and all the rest of it, or seat stays. Having a look down the tube, interesting. Have a look down there. Warning, not for off-road use or stunting. Well, I reckon I'll be using it off-road, but one other note. Have a look at the manual here. Current as at October 2006, so I guess the manual's just sort of a general thing. But just a quick one. There's the seat, and right about where my thumb is, or maybe my index finger, there's a little mark saying minimum insertion, so you get the idea. That's how much you can insert the seat into the tube. Incidentally, it's a San Marco seat, and right over here, currently I've been riding a San Marco seat for a few years on my road bike. Okay, here it is mostly assembled. I've still got to tighten the steering, but on that note, I think the stem is measured from the center, and I think it's supposed to be 90 millimeters. I might actually flip that upside down for a slightly more forward or aggressive stance.
Okay, I've already flipped over the stem. You can see it here before and then after. I think it looks better and it suits me better, so there you go.